Hello everyone, welcome to GIS Man, I'm Miles Lee. This video is to continue with the last episode about how to implement the customized widgets of ArcGIS Experience Builder to retrieve and consume the instant GeoJSON from AWS. So in last video, we have already implemented the basic functions which can retrieve and consume all features from the GeoJSON. For example, when we click on the button, all features from the GeoJSON will be pop up and they will be turned into the GeoJSON layer, and the layer will be added to the layers collection of the map. And when we click on any point, we can see the live traffic camera photo. But however, this is not what we want finally. Our target is to only search and show the camera points surrounding a certain location. For example, if we click on any location in Sydney, and then only the points surrounding and nearby within 5 kilometers will be shown up. So in order to do this, we need to do the spatial query as well as the attribute query in our code. So let's get started to take a look how to do that. So firstly, we will review our codes that have been done in last time. This is the function that we created last time. We create the functions to return the GeoJSON layer object, and this object definition is defined and inbuilt in the ArcGIS API for JavaScript. And we pass in our URL, which is our data source from AWS, and then we give the template and renderer which can help us to pop up the template correctly. Okay, and after that, in our main page, we implement two buttons. One is the show cameras button and the other one will be the clear layers button. And we implement two functions. The one is to create the GeoJSON layer, and the layer will be pushed into our layers collections in the map. And the other one will be clean all the layers. So this video, we will continue from here and we will implement our attribute query and spatial query. So let's get started. Before that, we will need to define a trigger event. So in our final widgets, what we need is that we click on any point and hold it for a while to trigger the retrieving and query events. So what we need is in our JMV object, JMV represent the Gmail map view. We bind our event hold to our view, and then we will pass an arrow function . The arrow function will have the variable event, and the event, we will need to stop the propagation. This can avoid trigger the event again and again. Okay, and then we will need to have a constant point, which is the point object equals to the state Gmail map view, the view to map. And here we will give an object as a variable, as a parameters. Actually, what we are doing here is to turn the screen X to the coordinate X, and screen Y, the screen pixel. to our coordinate X and Y. Okay. And after this, of course, like last time, we will need to create a layer. So we just copy and paste the code from our last implementation. We will firstly need to create a layer, and then we will need to define the query features. We will just need to define it. It's a graphic array. Okay. And then from here, we will need to do the attribute query first. For the attribute query, we will need to use our GeoJSON objects embed function called create query. And then we will give the query condition. We have a where clause. This is exactly like some SQL. For example, in SQL, we will usually do select something from a table, and then where, for example, the attribute equals to something. Yeah, it's exactly like this, but it's just written in JavaScript style. So we will give a like, total like, anything. Okay. This means that we want anything. We want everything at the beginning. If you don't understand, we can take a look on our cameras.geojson. In each feature, we will have five attributes in the property. For example, like the region, title, view, direction, and link to the live traffic camera photo. So for title, every feature will be different. So here we will need to use this style, the title like 2% to match anything, everything in our GeoJSON. Okay, and then the query attribute, we will need to explode every fields. This is our query condition. And after defining our query condition, of course, we will need to query. So we use a function called query features, and then pass in the parameter, which is our query condition, just defined. And then we will use the promise to handle our response. Again, there will be an arrow function here. And then our graphic array, which just defined, will be equal to our response features. Here we can get all features from our response, okay? Response features. And then we will use apply edits of our GeoJSON layer object to commit the operation. Here, what we need to do is to delete all the features at the beginning. Some people said, why we need to do that? Because when we firstly retrieve and use our data source from the AWS, we defaultly get all the features, and turn it into a GeoJSON layer. And then in order to pop up our preferred features, instead of all the features, we will need to delete this first. And then once we delete this, we will do another spatial query to pop up our preferred only features and camera points. Okay, so this is the logic why we need to do this. So this apply edit is just like commit. For example, in some database, we will have something, and then commit, which can, you know, like to confirm our operations. So after this, we will need to do our spatial query. So in our spatial query, which is quite similar, we need to define our query condition. The query spatial will be equals to GeoJSON layer object dot create query. This is exactly same as our attribute query, but the condition will be a little bit different. We will use the geometry. The geometry will be our point. The point is the one that we defined by our hold event. When we click and hold for a second on the screen, it will turn our screen XY into the map coordinate XY by two map functions and turn it into the points geometry. And the query spatial geometry will be equals to this point, which means that we will get the location whenever we click. So after this, we will need to have a query condition. Query spatial, we use the distance. Distance will be equals to 3. What we want is within 5 kilometers, because 3 miles will be equals to 5 kilometers, around 5 kilometers. Yeah. The units will be miles. Of course, we can also use kilometers, does not matter. So here we can give a 5 kilometers distance, and then query spatial, you need to have a spatial relationship. There are lots of spatial relationship as normal GIS operations, like contains, crosses, disjoin, overlaps, but we use intersects. We use the intersect, which means that when we click a point, and then you can assume there will be a transparent circle of 5 kilometers, and then any features within and intersect this circle polygons will be queried and will be found out. Okay, so this is what we want, and query spatial dot return geometry. Of course, we will need to return the geometry, so we give it a 2. And what else is let me think, outfields. Yeah, no matter we do the attribute query or spatial query, we return all the fields. And after that, we will need to do the query. This is the definitions of our query conditions, and here is the query. Of course, we will need to change our parameters name, and response equals to query features equals to response dot features, no problem. And then we also need to commit. This time we will need to add features. Add features, we will need to add all the things that satisfy this query condition. Okay, so after this, we will need to just push the layer into our maps layers collection. Okay, let's take a look if we mix anything. Points, define the layers, and then query by attribute, and after that commit our deletion, and then query by spatial, after commit our addition, and then put everything into our layers. Okay, so I suppose is everything is correct. We just format our code a little bit and you can try to run. So in our transition functions, we can still retrieve all the features from the GeoJSON. And by hold and by click on the location and hold for a while, we will retrieve only the locations, only the points that within a certain kilometers. So this is exactly what we want. We click here again, and then only the points that's around 5 kilometers will be shown. Okay, do it again. Yeah, only the points that surrounding five kilometers will be shown. We click all. We test again. Everything should be good. It's exactly like what our final product on our left hand side, if you take a look. If we click on any point, it will show up the camera points that's around our click locations, about 5 kilometers. Okay, so that's it. Everything should be fine. We have implemented the functions of consuming the GeoJSON from AWS and show our live traffic cameras, which is good. Okay, thank you everyone. Thanks for watching and please stay tuned for other more exciting videos. Thank you and bye.